Research aims at producing new knowledge. It is largely driven by human curiosity. The motivation to push knowledge beyond the boundary of what is currently known is intrinsic in human nature and has led humans to dominate the world. According to Dante's compelling words spoken by Ulysses in Inferno, Canto 26, Fatti non foste a viver come bruti, ma per seguir virtute e conoscenza. Ye were not formed to live the life of brutes, but virtue to pursue and knowledge high. Today, we recognize that research is not only an irrepressible human aspiration, but also the fundamental source of progress for society. The causal link between scientific research and progress, however, became only evident in the past 3-4 centuries. The foundations for scientific research were laid in the early 17th century with the contributions of Francis Bacon, Galileo Galilei, and Isaac Newton. We will go deeper into these contributions in a later lecture, which will focus on the scientific method. Since then, the world witnessed a phenomenal and unprecedented growth in human power. The notion that scientific research drives progress became evident, and humans realized that they could increase their capabilities by investing in scientific research. This wasn't just blind faith, it was repeatedly proven by empirical evidence. This led wealthy people and governments to invest in research. As we can see, research produces more power, which generates resources that can fuel further research. Sometimes a distinction is made between basic research, also called pure or fundamental, and applied research. Sometimes the distinction is between scientific research and technological research. This distinction can be traced back to 1944, 1 year before the end of World War II, when USA President Roosevelt asked Vannevar Bush, head of the Office of Scientific Research and Development during war, to advise him on the role of research during peace. Bush produced a report which influenced the developments and funding initiatives worldwide. Bush introduced the term basic research to indicate research performed without thought of practical ends. Basic research contributes to knowledge and is only driven by curiosity. The creativity needed to do basic research would be lost if research is finalized to a premature attention to its practical usage. Applied research, instead, is problem-driven and more predictable. Its goal is to deliver potentially practical results. According to Bush, basic research is the pacemaker of technological progress. Its discoveries are taken up by applied research, which then leads to the developments of innovations, such as new products or processes. Although Bush's stand in defense of unconstrained basic research is still very valuable, the mechanistic view of linear process progressing from basic to applied research and then into innovations is not realistic. In practice, the process is not linear. There is a constant feedback from practice to ideas of new research and from ideas to practice. It is hard to say which comes first and which comes next. Fundamental research questions may arise from the complexity of real problems, from attempts to open new unexplored directions or to try radically different solutions to known problems. The distinction between pure and applied research is often fuzzy. It is true, however, that problems arising in the real world may be solved through more or less radically new and challenging research approaches. The closer research goals are to the current practice, the more likely research results will provide incremental practical benefits and gains. Exploration of more radical approaches may instead be more risky. They may not lead to benefits in the short term, but they may lead to future high gains. All forms of research can be equally important for progress. The term research and development, R&D, is often used to indicate the entire spectrum of activities from purely speculative to practically inspired research to pre-competitive developments of prototype solutions. Governments, public and private institutions, invest in R&D by paying salaries to researchers and funding their ideas presented as research proposals. Here we can see the data on worldwide research investment published by the UNESCO. The circles show how much countries are spending on R&D. Countries farther to the right are spending relatively more in terms of their GDP. Those closer to the top have higher numbers of researchers per 1 million inhabitants. You can easily observe how investments in research correlate to the developments of a country.